that the early stages of hard work and focus are gonna feel like agitation, stress, and confusion, because that's the norepinephrine and adrenaline system kicking in. None of us would expect to walk into the gym and do our PR lift or, you know, a performer go do something without warming up. The brain also needs to warm up and start to hone in which circuits are gonna be active. And it's unreasonable for us to think, oh, I've got an hour, I'm gonna plop down and write beautifully for an hour, my best.
What if adopting the mindsets of the super successful could be the key to unlocking your true potential? If you wanna know how rich people think so that you will be successful in solving your problems and other difficulties, you need to watch this video till the end. I'll be showing you 5 key neuroscience insights behind the thinking patterns of successful individuals. In the Rich Roll podcast titled Change Your Brain, attorney Rich Roll interviewed Dr. Andrew Huberman, a neuroscientist and neurobiology professor at Stanford Medical School. Andrew studies the brain, brain plasticity, and brain regeneration. His lab does research on topics including fear, courage, mindset, stress, anxiety, and trauma. So how rich people think differently. These insights will provide a glimpse into how successful individuals might leverage neuroscience to enhance their performance and achieve their goals. 1. Dopamine action. Dr. Huberman talks about the dopamine action in the body, which suppresses norepinephrine and keeps us motivated to work harder. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter that plays a role in how we feel pleasure. It's a big part of our unique human ability to think and plan. It helps us strive, focus, and find things interesting.
Once you start accomplishing your goal, the reward systems like dopamine start kicking in. But I think if people are interested in modifying their brain for the better, at least some, you know, top contour understanding of how urgency and focus must converge for that to happen can be useful, because I think there's a lot of attention paid to whether or not something feels like flow.
Successful entrepreneurs like Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos are known for their relentless drive and ambition. This could be linked to the dopamine action in their bodies, which keeps them motivated to work harder and achieve their goals. 2. Managing dopamine levels. Dr. Huberman suggests several ways to manage dopamine levels to enhance motivation, such as viewing early morning sunlight for 10 to 30 minutes daily, taking a 1 to 3 minute cold shower, and eating tyrosine-rich foods. Tyrosine-rich foods like sesame seeds, soybeans, beef skirt steak, lean chicken breast, and spirulina, blue-green algae.
The dopamine system is really important to understand. So we've talked about norepinephrine kind of gets you going. Acetylcholine is the spotlight of attention. The dopamine system is Mother Nature's hardwired, ancient system in all animals, including humans, to put us on the right path. Now, a lot of people talk about dopamine as this thing that you get when you publish the book, or when you get the book deal, or when something wonderful happens, like your child's born, and that's true. But dopamine's main role is to be released anytime you achieve a milestone or you think you're on the right path. And when the dopamine system is tethered to a particular pattern of focus, remember duration, path, and outcome. So it's like, oh, you sit down, maybe you don't get much text out, but then the next day you get 800 words of really solid text and you feel good, like I'm into this.
By managing their dopamine levels, successful people can sustain their motivation over time. It can also enhance our depth of focus and lower our threshold for taking action towards specific goals. High-performing athletes like LeBron James and Tom Brady might manage their dopamine levels to enhance motivation. They might be doing the suggested methods mentioned by Dr. Huberman. 3. Neuroplasticity. Neuroplasticity is the ability of our brains to form and reorganize synaptic connections, especially in response to learning or experience or following injury.
Because most people don't realize this, but neuroplasticity is triggered by intense focus. But neuroplasticity occurs during deep sleep and rest. And we can talk about how to optimize those different brain functions. One of the things that's really important also to think about how the brain works in terms of plasticity and all this stuff is what the brain really wants to do is also pass as much of what it does off to reflexive behavior as possible.
This concept is key to understanding how rich people think differently. They are often lifelong learners, constantly seeking new experiences and knowledge, which helps them adapt and succeed in various situations. Lifelong learners like Bill Gates and Warren Buffett constantly seek new experiences and knowledge. This helps them adapt and succeed in various situations, demonstrating the concept of neuroplasticity. 4. Success mindset. Dr. Huberman discusses the importance of having a success mindset and literally rewiring our brains for growth. This involves maintaining a sense of playfulness, leveraging dopamine for goal pursuit, and practicing gratitude.
And this starts to bring us into the kind of like discussion around mindsets. Because so my colleague Carol Dweck, who popularized this theme, growth mindset, it's again a very misunderstood concept. It's the idea that we can change, so that's built into that. But the discovery of growth mindset was of these kids that actually really enjoyed doing problem sets that they knew they couldn't get right. But for them, they would get this like dopamine release from just focusing on the problem. They liked doing puzzles they couldn't get right. It sounds crazy, but inevitably those kids are very good at puzzles and very good at math and these kinds of things. So growth mindset is, I believe, if it's sort of a neuroscience lens on growth mindset, would be that the agitation and stress that you feel at the beginning of something and when you're trying to lean into it and you can't focus is just a recognized gate. You have to pass that through that gate to get to the focus component. And then if you can reward the effort process, you really start to feel joy and low levels of excitement in the effort process. That's that buffering of adrenaline. That's that feeling like, yes, I've got a lot of adrenaline in my system, but I'm on the right path. Mm-hmm. It feels good to walk up this hill, so to speak. And when you start to bring those neural circuits together, you really start to create a whole set of circuits that are designed to be exported to any behavior you want.
Oprah Winfrey is known for her positive mindset and gratitude practice. She literally rewires her brain for growth, maintaining a sense of playfulness, leveraging dopamine for goal pursuit, and practicing gratitude. 5. Focus on outward goals. When our dopamine levels are elevated, we tend to focus our attention on outward goals, the things we want, and we feel motivated to pursue them. This is a common trait among successful individuals. Successful individuals like Mark Zuckerberg and Larry Page are known for their focus on outward goals. When their dopamine levels are elevated, they tend to focus their attention on the things they want and feel motivated to pursue them. How can you apply these tips in your daily life so that you will be successful? Here are some practical ways you can apply these neuroscience tips in your daily life. On dopamine action, set clear, achievable goals for yourself and break them down into smaller tasks. Each time you accomplish a task, your brain will release dopamine, which will motivate you to continue working towards your larger goals. 2. Managing dopamine levels. Incorporate healthy habits into your daily routine to help manage your dopamine levels. This could include getting exposure to early morning sunlight, taking cold showers, and eating a balanced diet. Balanced diet that includes tyrosine-rich foods, sesame seeds, soybeans, beef skirt steak, lean chicken breast and spirulina, blue-green algae, homemade granola, oats, regular and quick, not fortified dry, and toasted wheat germ. You can also eat or drink probiotic foods. Certain species of bacteria can produce dopamine, which may impact mood and behavior. How cold is the water to release dopamine? The temperature of a cold shower to release dopamine can vary. One study showed significant and prolonged increases in dopamine when people were in cool water at about 15.6 degrees Celsius, 60 degrees Fahrenheit, for about an hour. Other studies describe significant increases in dopamine from just 20 seconds in very cold water at approximately 4.4 degrees Celsius, 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Another research suggests that dopamine concentrations increased by 250% at 32 degrees Celsius, but saw a 530% increase at 14 degrees Celsius. However, it's important to note that the exact temperature can vary based on individual tolerance and the desired effect. The key is to aim for a temperature that evokes the thought, this is really cold, and I want to get out, but I can safely stay in. Always prioritize safety when trying cold showers for dopamine release. 3. Neuroplasticity. Embrace lifelong learning. Read books, take online courses, or learn a new skill. This will help your brain form new connections and improve its ability to adapt to new situations. 4. Success mindset. Practice positive thinking and gratitude. Start each day by writing down 3 things you're grateful for. This can help rewire your brain for positivity and growth. 5. Focus on outward goals. Keep your goals in mind and visualize achieving them. This can help increase your dopamine levels and motivate you to work towards your goals. 6. Dopamine prediction error. This means that the response to the reward itself disappears when the reward is predicted. But if more than the predicted reward occurs, the dopamine neurons show stronger responses. Set goals that are slightly out of your comfort zone. The discrepancy between the expected reward, comfort zone, and the actual reward, achieving the challenging goal, can create a dopamine prediction error, which can motivate you and drive learning. You can adapt the slogan of Yes Theory YouTubers to seek discomfort. Seeking discomfort is all about stepping outside of your comfort zone to accomplish incredible things you would have otherwise chosen not to do. 7. Adequate sleep. Getting enough sleep is essential for maintaining healthy dopamine levels. It's also crucial to remember that while these neurological factors can influence our behaviors and thinking patterns, they don't determine them. Personal values, experiences, and choices also play a significant role in shaping our paths to success. Remember, success is a journey, not a destination. It's about consistent progress and personal growth. These tips are not a guarantee of success, but they can certainly help you develop the mindset and habits that are often associated with successful people. Good luck on your journey to success! All the scientific research references used in this video are linked down below. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button below and subscribe for more content like this. Be a helper. There you have it. Take care of yourself and your health. Thanks for watching to the end, and I'll see you in the next video.